Maybe Rodgers and I just kibitzing, and I'm glad we were. You know, like films from the Rapture, the Mirror has two faces, and of course the Austin Powers, international man of mystery, now a new political thriller. It's called Affairs of State. We're glad you're here, and I tell you what, I'm going to pull our private conversation public for just a second, because we were talking about the commitment to character and how Mike Myers now plays the host of the Gong
right.
Show.
Yeah.
So when you were doing Austin Powers, people thought, you know, the result, hilarious.
Yeah, it's such a funny movie. Yeah. People were like, oh my God, that's, that must have been so, and it was fun and hilarious, and during takes, I could rarely ever keep a straight face because Mike was just insanely hilarious. But between takes, Mike was deadly serious.
Really?
Like, he takes his craft so seriously. So, you know, we'd do a take and he'd be reviewing and monitoring, and it was like very, very specific, very serious. We'd do another take and he'd be, you know, crazy, silly again. And I always was so horrified when I would break up because it's like, oh my God, he's gonna get mad.
Yeah, yeah. And it's probably hard not to break up. Yeah,
it's so hard not to break
up. And that phrase, which people say all the time, and you might have an opinion one or the other, is comedy indeed harder than drama?
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's no question. Because in comedy, timing is essential. The words are essential. The order of the words are essential. You'll get people coming into a comedy set who think that they can, you know, contemporize with the words or, you know, change the order, that can screw up the whole thing. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, it's definitely harder.
All right, Affairs of State here about an aide who'll do anything to gain power.
Yes.
And how do you play a role in all this?
All right, so he comes to work for my husband, who's a very conservative candidate running for president, and I'm a little bit of a Lady Macbeth.
Oh.
And I get a little inappropriate with the aide.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, with that in mind, I'm now more interested in the clip. here we go. Let's take a look. Adrian Grenier, I saw, was in the clip.
Yes.
Lots of good folks in it. Watch this.
Who is this? Senator, this is Michael Lawson. He's going to be working for us.
Fantastic. Well, welcome aboard, Michael.
Thank you, sir.
You're a good-looking kid, you know that?
Thank you, sir.
Isn't he? Isn't he, Judith?
Isn't who what?
Darling, I was just saying, Michael Lawson here is coming to work for us. I said he was a good-looking young man. Don't you think?
Yes. And that is so important in a campaign.
Uh-oh. Now, how close do we get to all these people?
Rather close.
Yeah. Oh. just because you've had the experience, is that fun or is it like, all these people are seeing me in my nightgown, or...
Oh, it's not fun at all. No. It's interesting. You go into a safe zone.
Right.
Once the director says action, mm-hmm. sort of everything falls away. And at least it does for me. And you're kind of in this safe zone. But before and after, it's horribly embarrassing and awkward. And I do get involved with the young aide, and he's very young. And I was horrified about that. I kind of had to get over that myself, to be able to kind of act properly.
I'm always obsessed with this. We talk about it here all the time. Is there a pre-kissing conversation? Like, I like double mint.
Here's the thing. I mean, we like to hope that everybody's considerate and make sure, you know, that they don't have stank breath and all that. But these scenes end up being very specifically choreographed. And so there's a lot of pre-shooting conversation about how it's going to happen, because it's not like the script can tell you this hand is going here and then you're going to do that and this and then, you know. And if they're not sort of well choreographed, it can...
There could be an accidental grope or what?
Well, it can just look very staged and artificial.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You know, you're trying to simulate a reality. So...
So is that hard for you when you watch the finished product, when you see a movie or a show you've done, and then that scene, you know, shows up?
Sometimes can be a little creepy.
But
now, like when I'm kissing David James Elliott, it's fine.
Okay. Right.
When I'm making out with the 23-year-old.
Yeah. Now, how did he tell you how he felt? Because he knows who you were. Yeah.
Too.
He's going, wait a minute.
He's like 23, going on 50. He's like, it's fine. It'll be no problem.
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
This is familiar ground for me.
That's why he's so wonderful in this role. He has this gravity and maturity that far exceed his years.
All right, Nini, real life, you're a really good poker player.
I'm okay, yeah.
And you, but see, I'll be honest with you. I find Hold'em boring.
Yeah. It's all in your mindset, because for me, it's like a chess match. Mm. And there's a great, great deal of technique and education into playing the game properly. So that's the challenge for me. And yeah, when you're getting crappy cards and nothing's happening, it can get quite dull. Uh-huh. But overall, I find it fascinating.
Is there a particular pot, you know, we always see those poker things on TV where somebody goes like, you know, what, is there a best pot that you've ever raked in?
Well, yeah, the more money, the better.
Spoken like a true player. Yeah. Affairs of State released in select theaters and on demand today.
Today.
Yay, go see it. Mimi,
definitely
come back.
Thank you, Mimi. Just one time
to.
We want to be able to do that on the table.
Just one
time.
I've done it a couple times. Yeah.
You got to pay the mortgage between those movie roles, right?
Thanks, Mimi. Great to see you.
Thanks.